Hi there, YouTube friends. This is Shosie G, and I wanted to show you the rest of... There's Day-Day walking by, like, casually. Anyway, Tinky's trying to get into a doll, I can see. It's a Christmas present. Anyway, I should show you this doll really quickly. Let me show you this doll. Let me back up real quick. I think she's an Elsa doll, but I've never seen her before. Ever. Who is she? Isn't she cute? She's got, like, green eyes, not blue. But, you know, of course she's dressed in a new dress because this is what the person made for her and dressed her in. We got her at a doll show. These are her hands. And I haven't taken her out of the bag to really look at her markings, but she's got side-glancing eyes, and she looks sad. I don't think, and I can't see the back of her hair because she's got paper there, so I have to take her out of the bag, but I don't think she's an Elsa doll at all, which is interesting. Okay, anyway, tell me what you think, okay? All right, on with the show. All right, this is what drives me crazy, though. This is not good. You can see four floors here. We have the floor from the family room, the kitchen floor. Here's a floor that we had to put in because it had to be like a transient floor in a way, because you cannot walk on the comic book floor. Not really. You're not supposed to have shoes on the comic book floor because it's very fragile. Okay? So here's the kitchen. The kitchen I haven't really done much in. I cleaned it. Wow. All right. It needs some updates. It's 11 years old. Okay, you wouldn't think, oh, 11 years is not bad. Yeah, yeah, it's bad. All right, so this is the comic book floor. And it looks pretty decent, although you cannot read the individual comics because I didn't get a clear polyurethane. I got one with the hue in it, which I did not... No, there was a clear polyurethane. Well, I knew there was in a way, but I didn't want to spend $44 a gallon. And I had to use 3 gallons. Can you imagine? I already spent on this floor alone $75 just in polyurethane. Just in polyurethane. Not counting all the comics, not counting all the glue. You know, so phew, this is an expensive floor. And I mean, this is a big room, so I probably would have spent a whole lot more on just, engineered flooring. And so I got off cheap, but it was a lot of work, and it smells horrid. I mean, it was bad. Okay, so anyway, we had to put this vinyl flooring in so you can have a walkway from here to the hallway where I have 3 bedrooms and a bathroom. This bedroom on this side is my doll room, which I don't dare take you in because you would be horrified, okay? All right. Only because it's a disaster area. I can't even walk in there anymore. This room is the bathroom ahead of you, and then I have the newly remodeled guest room that I've showed you. And then here, this wall here, behind here, is my library, which I can't take you in right now either. That's a disaster. All right, so those are rooms I have to work on. Christmas break's coming up. Okay, so here's the bar to the kitchen. And by the way, this little stool here, this step stool, I've known this step stool my whole life. It was my grandma's, my grandma's, and on my mom's side, and I used to step on it and lean over the sink, and she used to wash my hair when I was a baby. So that's pretty cool that I have that. I got it when my mom passed away, and she tried to give me a knockoff one year because I wanted this one, and I wouldn't have it. So anyway, here's the stools. I guess I forgot that bag there. Forgot to put it away. It's a Christmas present. But anyway, in this, I wanted to show you this. This isn't well lit, but this is my grandma's china cabinet. And in there, I have everything from my son's, you can't really see those. Sorry, they're not well lit Wish I had better lighting over here. I do not. Shoes. They're bronzed shoes. To my great right there. To my great grandmother's tea set. Very fragile. Don't touch it. Yep. And to my mom's De Grazia plates, which are in shatters, because somebody, I won't mention who, didn't pack them properly, unfortunately. And I have some really nice keepsakes of my grandma's, and then just some really fun things in there. I have a Uban coffee. You can't even see that. Okay, so anyway, got some fun stuff in there with some sand in it that reminded me of my Uncle Herb. I know it's silly, but it's there. Anyway, on the top, I've just got some, I made that, you've probably seen it in other videos. I made that, painted it, repainted it, and redecorated it, the mailbox. And yes, I have mannequins in my living room. And this, it was an old chalkboard that had a frame. I took the frame off and painted it. And one of these days, I keep saying I'm going to put sayings on there. Haven't done it yet. And there's the bike that Zach Sketch got me one year whenever we were in a car accident and my car was almost totaled, not quite. And I had to walk back and forth to work. And he got me this bike. That was pretty cool. So that made it a lot easier. These chairs, I had four of them, but because of somebody, I won't mention any names, Monday. Anyway, got into some kind of a, I don't know, toileting war on two of them. So these are the two that I have left of my brand new chairs. They're from hotels, actually. And so is this cool two-tiered. And it comes with that. It comes like that distressed. It's very cool. Well, I was going to do something with it. We were going to like decoupage it, things like that. But I have not done that yet. And this is one of my displays for Christmas. Moose and raccoon. Yeah. So are the lamps. I'm going to paint them silver, though. And then I like the melon on the bottom, but I don't know. I might do something with that. And then Jack Bear, years ago, made me this this cool divider because we found these. And then if you look, I hope you can see this. Can you see the twinkle lights outside? I don't know if you can see those or not. I can see them really well. But through the curtain, I can see them. I don't know if you can. But I can see them with my bare eyes. I have a gazebo on the other side. It's a patio, and there's twinkle lights on it. So I could see them through the window. That's pretty cool. Hope you're seeing that. And then over here, I just found this for like $5, this new mailbox. I love mailboxes. They're so cool. And I painted this years ago. It has a mate. The mate is white now. It was painted other colors, but now it's white. And I'm going to leave it that color because it goes with, as you can see behind it, the old hairdryer that's kind of a, well, somebody took it apart recently, but it's a lamp. I made it into a lamp. And then Zach Sketch painted this. It's like a Van Gogh. You can kind of tell. It was a coffee table, but he took the legs off of it. And then I've got to repaint this still. I'm probably going to paint it the same color, similar to what I painted the vent. See the vent down there? I'm going to paint it probably lighter than that because that's a little bit bright for me. Because it's old. I bought it at a thrift store years ago. It's really heavy duty. It's really super heavy, but it needs a new paint job because I never painted it properly to begin with, as you can tell. But then Zach Sketch and I redid these actually. We found these in the yard, and he took them kind of apart a little bit, and then he dry painted them, dry brushed them to give them flavor. And we hung them up on this wall after we repainted this room, because that used to be a brown wall, actually. And this was different colors, too. It was sponged two or three colors of brown and yellow or something. It was kind of hideous. Never really cared for it. I didn't like the way I did it. So we repainted it this white, and then we repainted this wall white as well. And then, sorry, I'm going too fast here, spinning around. And then we also painted this one green too, so you have like a green effect going through there. And then I just recently brought in my old rocking chair. I bought this rocking chair, oh gosh, like 5 years ago at a yard sale, but I totally love it. Not planning on doing anything with it. I really like the almond color. I love almond. It's a really good color, and I don't plan on repainting anything in here that's almond. And I do want to repaint this credenza because it's totally too dark. I know you shouldn't repaint everything that's wood, but I just got to do something with it. It's just too heavy and too dark, and I got to do something with it. But this turns on, and it's really cool. I should have lit it up for you. It's really super bright, and it pops against this. Let me see if I can light it up for you. And yes, here's another mannequin. You can see she's dressed in Old West stuff. Let's see if I can turn this on really cool, quickly for you. See, look, isn't that fun against that green wall? I love it. My youngest son, Joshua, gave me that for my birthday a year ago, the Munsters picture, because it's totally our family. And so the TV sits on it right now. It's an old TV, too. And then one of my mom's de gratias. And then all of my mom's keys. She love to collect things just like I do, and matchbooks and keys. One of these days I'll put her matchbooks in a big jar. But then in here, and here's my beautiful Walk Patty Play Pal reissue Walker doll. I love her. She's so cool. But I can't take her out of the package and I can't play with her. This room, I finally finished the flooring in here. It was terrible for a long time, but I need to do the wall, and I have an idea of how I'm going to do it. I want to put a tree here that goes up as far as I can. I found a really cool metal tree at Hobby Lobby. However, it's too short. I want a really long one, and it has to go past this and around that, so I'm thinking about making it myself. But you know, I need some wire hangers. You gotta really work that wire hanger thing. So this, and see, you can see the crack. There's a big crack right there in the ceiling. I gotta work on that. Zach Sketch, where are you? Okay, so anyway, this is the, and we cut a hole here. This was for Sig. This door used to be there. This used to be the kitten's room, but now, of course, as you know, it's the spare room. You recognize that flooring, huh? There's Rajaja right there, my baby. And then this, I can't take you in there, but this is the bathroom because Sig's in there right there. It's his condo. And then this is the library. One of these days I'll take you in there. And then this is my doll room. And one of these days I will definitely take you in there because I plan on working on that. It's going to have the same flooring similar to the spare bedroom. Okay, so let me give you real quick an overview here. I know this is running long. I apologize, but thank you so much for staying with you. I wanted to catch you up on what has been happening since I was last, we last worked on these spaces, and it's been a very long time since I got a chance to talk to you about them. All right, the comic book floor we're having an issue with. It doesn't want to stay down, so not really sure what I'm doing with that, but for right now, I love it, and I love the spaces. I just have to figure out a way to hang the de gratias without putting a lot of holes in the walls. I really don't want to do that because I really love this green wall. Green invigorates me, inspires me, makes me smile. All right, without this looking like a house from Florida, which Florida's great, but, you know, I don't live in Florida. I don't live in the Bahamas, which Bahamas are great, too, but I live in Arizona. You know what I mean? All right. Talk to you guys later. Tell me what you think. Take care. And I don't live in a box of crayons, either. Bye-bye.